One of the main pieces of technology that we used throughout the entirety of our research planning and evaluation was the internet. Without the internet, we really wouldn't have been able to complete the task that we needed to, as the internet formed a really main focal point for us, you know, carrying out our research planning and evaluation. We really wouldn't have been able to complete the task that we needed to, as the internet formed a really main focal point for us, you know, carrying out our research planning and evaluation. We use the internet for things such as, you know, creating our mood board, researching costumes for our artists, looking up locations and finding, you know, codes and conventions for our genre of music that we were choosing, which was alternative pop. You know, it was really important for us because without using the internet, we wouldn't have been able to, you know, bring together the whole image of our artists that we were trying to portray to our audience. We wouldn't have been able to find, you know, really cool locations, such as, you know, in our music video, there's actually a location in near Waterloo and it's like graffiti place, and without being able to research it on the internet, we really wouldn't have known about it. And we were the codes and conventions also, you know, we looked online and we looked at, you know, other genres that were similar to the music video that we were doing, which was alternative pop, and we were able to compare the two videos and really see, you know, what were the main codes and conventions that we used in that music video that we can then go on to mimic or challenge in our own. Another piece of equipment that we did use was this iPhone. It was really, really useful. I use this a lot more in year two than I did in year one of my course. We mainly used it just to blog on location. It was really, really useful and helpful. We could take our iPhones, because you can carry your iPhone with you anywhere. We took it with us and we filmed, you know, us filming our actual music video. Then when we came home, we would upload it and we'd use an app called iMovie, which is really, really useful, especially if you don't really have like a Mac, where you can just edit, you know, short clips on the app itself. You can download it on your iPhone, iPad, you know, your computer, and it was really, really useful and helpful. So that's why we used our iPhone as well. Two other pieces of technology that we used were lighting equipment and a camera that we were given to by our college. The lighting equipment, we didn't really use that much. What it was like a rectangular shaped light, and you can attach it to the camera, and this is like really useful if it's you know, if you're filming in the night time. When we actually went to Millennium Bridge, we did film in the night time. It was quite dark, it was winter, and we didn't use lights. So when we came back to college and uploaded it, we actually found that our images are quite blurry because there wasn't enough light focusing on our artists, so we actually did have to go back out again to Millennium Bridge to then film during the daytime. We also did use lighting when we were in the studio. These were like kind of like stands and they had lights on them, and we had like three or four of those. That again was really important because without the lights in our studio, again, the images would have come out extremely blurry. But we then had to find like a happy medium, because we actually did have an image of the sea projected onto our artist, and if the lights were too bright, you wouldn't see the background, but if they were too dark, then the image of our artist would be too blurry. So we did have to find like a kind of happy medium between the both. And the second piece of it was the camera. It was a Nikon. I don't really try to deny it when you show up. That it was like really useful because it filmed a music video. You know, it was good in terms of it was really up to date. It was one of the greatest things that helped us, you know, get on. But it hurts so good. Do you die again? Do you break it off when it hurts? But it hurts so good. Can you say it? Pieces of digital technology that we used were Premiere Pro and Photoshop. These were vital because without Premiere Pro we would not have a music video, and without Photoshop we wouldn't have an auxiliary. So for us, these two pieces of digital technology were essential. With these we were able to do some really cool effects, especially for me working on my auxiliary. I was really able to experiment with the tools. I'd never used Photoshop before, so we did spend a lot of time, you know, we did a practice run before of doing like our pretend poster and CD cover, and you know, you could really experiment and try out different things and see what you didn't like. And I think this allowed us to, you know, add a different element to our artist, because even though we were all working together in our music video, the ancillary was something that we did independently. So I feel like that allowed us individually to add a different aspect to our artist. And also Premiere Pro was really good, because, you know, we could add like loads of different effects in our music video, which you can actually see by looking at it, and it was really cool.